Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject Design of Transmission Systems. And this is lecture number 8.2. We are going to solve problems in the design of worm gear. In the earlier lecture, we discussed the design procedure of worm gear using the PSG design data book, and in this lecture we will solve three problems on the worm gear design using the PSG design data book. All the questions I am taking from Anna University question paper. So you listen to the lecture and you take a problem, practice on your own, so that you will remember the procedure of designing the worm gear, so that will help you to appear the university examination with confidently. Example number 1. A steel worm running at 240 rpm receives 1.5 kilowatt from its shaft. The speed reduction is 10. Design the drive so as to have an efficiency of 80%. Also determine the cooling area required if the temperature rise is restricted to 45 degrees Celsius. Take overall heat transfer coefficient as 10 watts per meter square degree Celsius. And this question was appearing in May 2016 question paper. We write down the given data. So, given data, power equal to 1.5 kilowatt, speed 240 rpm, and the speed reduction I equal to 10, efficiency 80%, 0.8, temperature rise 45 degree Celsius, and the heat transfer coefficient HC equal to 10 watts per meter square degree Celsius. So, first we have to calculate the speed ratio. It is given in the example. So, I equal to small z by capital Z. Small z, the number of teeth on the wheel, divided by number of start on the worm. Then we take the material. So, the material is given for worm, steel worm, and the wheel we assume cast iron. Because the power is very low, 1.5 kilowatt, we assume wheel material is cast iron. We have two choices, either cast iron or bronze. For lower power, we take cast iron and fix the number of start. So, that is Z equal to 3, capital Z equal to 3 for the speed reduction is 10. For higher speed reduction, the number of start will decrease. Then select the number of teeth on the wheel. So, small Z equal to 40 for the power is 1.5 kilowatt. So, if depending on the power again, so when the power is increasing, for lower power we can take 40, for higher power we can take 50 to 70. And we calculate the nominal twisting moment transmitted by the worm. So, MT equal to 97,420 in power in kilowatt, divided by worm speed in RPM into I into eta. I is the speed reduction, eta is the efficiency of the drive. Substitute numerical value is 97,420 into 1.5 divided by 240 into 10 into 0.8 equal to 4,871 kilogram 4 centimeter. Then we calculate the design twisting moment. We take KKD equal to 1 initially. So, design twisting moment or design torque equal to 4,871 kilogram 4 centimeter. Then we calculate the center distance. So, initially we assume the ratio Q equal to 11. The design surface test we take from the table 32, page number 8.45. Sigma C equal to 700 for cast iron wheel, assuming velocity, sliding velocity V equal to 2 meters per second. And this equation is also available in the page number 8.44. A equal to Z by Q plus 1 cubic root of 540 divided by Z by Q into sigma C whole square into the twisting torque, design torque. Substituting all the numerical values, A equal to 40 divided by 11 plus 1 cubic root of 540 divided by 40 by 11 into 700 whole square into 4871 equal to 27.95 centimeter. Then we calculate the equivalent number of teeth on the wheel. First, we calculate the lead angle gamma equal to tan inverse of capital Z by Q. Tan inverse of number of start equal to 3 by 11 equal to 15.25, and Z equivalent number of teeth on the wheel equal to Z divided by cos cube gamma which is 40 divided by cos cube 15.25 equal to 44.5. We make it as 45. Then we calculate the axial module. For axial module, we require the design bending stress. So we take from the table 33, page number 8.45. Sigma B equal to 400 for cast iron 35 material, rotation in one direction only. Form factor from the PhD data book, table 40, page number 8.53, y equal to 0.399 for z equivalent equal to 45 and the full 20 degree full depth. Then we calculate the axial module. The equation is 1.24 into design torque divided by z, small z, q y v sigma b to the power 1/3. So substituting 1.24 into 4871 divided by 40 into 11 into 0.399 into 400 to the power 1/3 equal to 0.51 centimeter. So we take the next higher standard module from table number 1, page number 8.2. So 0.55 centimeter or 5.5 millimeter. Now we calculate the center distance, A equal to 0.5 mx into q plus z. So substituting 0.5 into 0.55 into 11 plus 40 equal to 14 centimeter. And the center distance what is calculated here is less than the value calculated earlier. So we have to change the module, increase the module. And it is increased to 11 millimeter, mx equal to 11 millimeter modified. Instead of 0.55 centimeter, we are taking 1.1 centimeter now. Now the axial, center distance A equal to 0.5 mx into q plus z equal to 0.5 into 1.1 into 11 plus 40 equal to 28.05 centimeter. Now this value is higher than the previous value what we calculated earlier. Then we calculate the sliding velocity. So D1, sliding velocity, we have to calculate first D1, the pitch circle diameter of the worm, which is Q into MX. So 11 into 1.1 equal to 12.1 centimeter. Sliding velocity is pi D1N divided by 60 into cos gamma, pi into 0.121 into 240 divided by 60 into cos of 15.25 equal to 1.6 meters per second. Now the compressive stress from table number 32, page number 8.45 equal to 820 kilogram force per centimeter square for VS what we calculated 1.6 meters per second and the material is cast iron. Now the check for the surface stress, sigma C equation is 540 divided by Z by Q into square root of Z by Q plus 1 divided by A whole cube into design torque. So substituting all the values, sigma C equal to 540 divided by 40 by 11 into square root of 40 by 11 plus 1 divided by 28.05 whole cube into 4872 equal to 696.5, which is less than 820. So the actual compressive stress is less than the design compressive stress, so the design is safe. Then we have to check for the bending stress, sigma b equal to 1.9 into design torque divided by mx cube into q into z into yv. So substituting 1.9 into 4871 divided by 1.1 to the power 3 into 11 into 40 into 0.399 equal to 39.6, which is less than the design bending stress, which is 400. So the actual bending stress is less than the design bending stress, so the design is safe. Now we calculate the other dimensions of the worm gear drive. So D1, PCD of the worm, Q into MX, 11 into 1.1 equal to 12.1 centimeter. D2, PCD of the wheel, Z into MX, 40 into 1.1 equal to 44 centimeter. Face width, so the equation is there in the page number 8.48, table 38. B equal to 0.75 D1, so 0.75 into 12.1 equal to 9.1 centimeter. And L, length of the worm, from table number 39, page number 8.48, L equal to 12.5 plus 0.09 in the number of teeth into MX, axial module, which is 12.5 plus 0.09 into 40 into 1.1 equal to 17.71 centimeter. So at the end of the problem, we have to calculate all the dimensions. We take next example, example number 2. A 2 kilowatt power is applied to a worm shaft at 720 rpm. The worm is of quadruple start type with a 50 millimeter as the pitch circle diameter. The worm gear has 40 teeth with a 5 mm module. The pressure angle is the diameter plane. In the diameter plane is 20 degree. Determine lead angle of the worm, velocity ratio, center distance. Also calculate the efficiency of the worm gear drive and the power lost in the friction. So this was in May 2011 and May 2008 question paper. And here we are not going to follow the conventional design procedure for worm gear, because many of the data, module value is given, number of teeth is given, PCD of the worm wheel is given. So we have to calculate whatever is asked here. Determine the lead angle, velocity ratio, center distance, everything we have to calculate. We have to calculate the power lost in the friction. So we write down the given data. Power equal to 2 kilowatt. Speed of the worm 720 rpm, number of start equal to 4, quadruple, number of start equal to 4, number of teeth on the wheel equal to 40, axial module is 5 mm, diameter D1 equal to 50 mm and alpha pressure angle 20 degree. So first calculation, speed ratio or velocity ratio, I equal to Z, small z by capital Z, number of teeth on the wheel divided by number of start of the worm, 40 by 4 equal to 10. Then we select the material. So material is not mentioned here. We take steel and cast iron. So worm is made by steel and wheel is made by cast iron. And number of start equal to Z equal to 4 given in the problem. Number of teeth on the wheel, small Z equal to 40 given in the problem. And we have to calculate module. Axial module is also given in the problem, 5 mm. Then we have to calculate the lead angle. For lead angle, first we require the Q, the ratio D1 by MX equal to 50 by 5 equal to 10. So gamma lead angle of the worm is tan inverse of capital Z by Q equal to tan inverse of 4 by 10 equal to 21.8 degrees. Then we calculate the sliding velocity. So the D1 diameter pitch circle diameter of the worm 50 mm is given. Then we calculate the sliding velocity Vs equal to pi D1 n divided by 60 into cos gamma. So pi into 0.05 into 720 divided by 60 into cos 21.8 equal to 2 meters per second. Now we have to calculate the efficiency of the drive. So for calculating efficiency of the drive, we have to refer to the graph. It is in page number 8.49. We have to have two angles to calculate the efficiency. One is rho, friction angle, and gamma is lead angle. So lead angle already we have calculated. We require the friction angle. To calculate the friction angle, we have to refer to the graph. Now, we have rho. So, we have calculated Vs equal to 2 meters per second. And our material is cast iron. So, for 2 meters per second, we draw one vertical line. It is meeting here. And the mu value, so corresponding to this point, the mu value, I have taken 0.066. So, rho, you listen to the graph, mu equal to tan rho. So, I calculate rho, the friction angle, rho equal to tan inverse of mu, which is tan inverse of 0.066, which is 3.77. Then we calculate the efficiency, eta. So, this efficiency equation is also available in the page number 8.49, eta equal to tan gamma by tan gamma plus rho. So, tan 21.8 divided by tan 21.8 plus 3.77 equal to 0.836, which is 83.6%. That is the efficiency of the drive. Then the center distance we calculate, A equal to 0.5 mx into Q plus Z. Everything is given, all the values are given, just we have to calculate 0.5 into mx equal to 0.5, Q equal to 10 and Z equal to 40, which is 12.5 centimeter. Then the power lost in the friction, so efficiency, 1 minus efficiency in the power of the drive. So 1 minus eta into power, that is equal to 1 minus 0.836 into 2000. 2 kilowatt is the power, 2000 equal to 328 watts. This is the power lost in the friction. The example number 3. So, from the question paper November 2012 and May 2005, design a worm gear drive with a standard center distance to transmit 7.5 kilowatt from a worm rotating at 1440 rpm to a worm wheel at 20 rpm. So, we are given power 7.5 kilowatt, pinion worm speed 1440 rpm and the wheel speed 20 rpm. So, we select the material. So, material is not mentioned here. We take always worm is steel and we take wheel material as a bronze. Now, fix the number of start, Z equal to 2 for the initially we take z equal to 2 because the power is high. Then select the number of teeth on the wheel, z equal to 50 for the power of 7.5 kilowatt. Then we calculate the speed ratio, i equal to capital I, number of teeth on the wheel divided by number of start of the worm. 50 divided by 2 equal to 25. 25 is the speed ratio in this problem. Then we take the efficiency from the table 37 in the PhD data book, eta equal to 0.8 for number of start z equal to 2. Then we calculate the nominal twisting moment, mt equal to 97,420 into power in kilowatt divided by the worm speed into I into eta. So calculating 97,420 into 7.5 divided by 1440 into 25 into 0.8 equal to 10,147.9 kilogram per centimeter. Then we take the design twisting moment, taking KKD equal to 1 initially, so MT equal to within bracket equal to MT, this is twisting moment into KKD, it is again 10,147.9 kilogram per centimeter. Then we calculate the center distance, so initially we take Q equal to 11, the design surface stress from the table 32 page number 8.45, sigma C equal to 1680 for bronze wheel, assuming velocity V equal to 2 meters per second. So, now the material is bronze. So, according to the material, the sigma C, material and the V value, the sigma C is changing. Now, center distance A equal to Z by Q plus 1 into cubic root of 540 divided by Z by Q into sigma C into design torque. So, substitute numeric value is 50 by 11 plus 1 into cubic root of 540 divided by 50 by 11 into 1680 into 10,147.9. equal to 23.82 centimeter. Then we calculate the equivalent number of teeth on the wheel. First we calculate the lead angle gamma equal to tan inverse of capital Z by Q, which is tan inverse of 2 by 11 equal to 10.3, and Z equivalent equal to Z by cos cube gamma, which is 50 divided by cos cube 10.3 equal to 52.5. We make it as 53. Now to calculate the axial module, we require the design bending stress. From the table 33, page number 8.45, sigma B equal to 780 for bronze and rotating in one direction only. The form factor for 53, Z equivalent equal to 53 and the 20 degree full depth, YV equal to 0.4122. So, the axial module, MX equal to 1.24 into design torque divided by number of teeth Z, Q diameter factor Q, YV into sigma B. So, substitute to the power 1 by 3. Substitute numeric values 1.24 into 10,147.9 divided by 50 into 11 into 0.4122 into 780 to the power 1 by 3 equal to 0.48 centimeter. Then the next higher module from the table number 1, page number 8.2, mx equal to 0.5 centimeter or 5 millimeter. Now we calculate the center distance. So, a equal to 0.5 into mx into q plus z. So, 0.5 into 0.5 into 11 by 11 plus 50 equal to 15.25, and the center distance is now what we calculate, the center distance is less than the value what we calculated earlier. So, we have to change the module, increase the module, and the module is increased to 10 millimeter. Instead of 5 millimeter, I am changing the module to 10 millimeter. Now, we calculate the center distance, A equal to 0.5 into mx into q plus z. Equal to 0.5 into 1 into 11 plus 50 equal to 25.5 centimeter, which is higher than the previous value. Then the sliding velocity, we have to calculate the pitch circle diameter of the worm, q into mx, 11 into 1, 11 centimeter, and the sliding velocity, vs equal to pi d1n divided by 60 into cos gamma, which is pi into 0.11 into 1440 divided by 60 into cos 10.3 equal to 8.42 meters per second. Now we take the compressive stress from the table 32, page number 8.45. Sigma C equal to 1490 kilogram force per centimeter square for Vs equal to 8.4 meters per second and the material is bronze. Then check for the surface stress. Sigma C equal to 540 divided by Z by Q into square root of Z by Q plus 1 to divided by A to the power 3 into design torque. So, substituting numeric value is 540 divided by 50 by 11 into square root of 50/11+1 divided by 25.5 to the power 3 into 10147.9, that is equal to 1213.7, which is less than 1490. So the actual compressive stress is less than the design compressive stress. So the design is safe. Then we have to check for the bending stress. Sigma b equal to 1.9 into design torque divided by mx cube, axial module to the power 3, diameter factor, number of teeth into yv. So substituting 1.9 into 10147.9 divided by 1 cube into 11 into 50 into 0.4122 equal to 85, which is less than 780. The design bending stress 780. So the actual bending stress is less than the design bending stress. So the design is safe. Now we calculate the other dimensions of the worm gear drive. PCD of the worm, already we have calculated 11 cm. PCD of the wheel, Z into MX, 50 into 1 equal to 50 cm. Face width, the equation is available in the page number 8.48. B equal to 0.75 D1, 0.75 into 11 equal to 7.81 cm. Length of the worm, it is available in the table number 39. L equal to 12.5 plus 0.09, Z into MX, which is 12.5 plus 0.09 into 50 into 1 equal to 17 centimeter. So we stop here. So these are all the books I published in mechanical engineering, and I upload the video lectures in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel and use the videos for your better learning. And thank you for watching. So you can please post your comments in your in the comments box. You can contact me for any clarification on the subject. We'll meet again in another video lectures with additional problems in the worm gear design. Until then, bye.